Round one. The fighters both approach each other on the front foot. Jermell throws a jab to the body. Let's take note. The body jab is the punch that started the contest, and it would be the punch that would end this contest. Rosario stays front foot heavy while Jermell circles to his left. Both fighters stay engaged while on their front foot. Rosario fires off a couple of jabs. Mel defends by catching the jab or stepping off the line. It looks to me that while both fighters have good size, Jermell is the more athletic or dynamic of the two. Jermell finally was able to time Rosario's jab and fire a looping right hand over his jab, but it just missed. However, this forced Rosario onto his back foot. Mel immediately followed by getting heavy on his front foot, pushing Rosario back, knocking him out of position, and slamming a left hook to the top of Rosario's head, dropping him. Jermell Charlo is powerful. Jeison Rosario is a tough kid, and he fought well enough throughout the rest of the round. He went to a high guard, got on his front foot, and pressure forward. I believe Jermell cruised the rest of the round knowing that he had the knockdown in the bag. Okay, so that's the end of the first round, but let's dig a little deeper into that knockdown. Jermell is the more dynamic fighter. We can see that. He can slip between his front foot position and the back foot position much more fluidly than Rosario. Rosario plods along mainly on his front foot. He gave a few perfunctory head feints, but he never fired off of them. Jermell wasn't really feigning either, but he was baiting Rosario with his jab, laying a trap by settling up on his front foot. Rosario pushed his jab forward and sprung Jermell's trap, which led to the knockdown. All right, round two. Jermell comes out and fights more aggressively. He is doing well to maintain his preferred distance, but he is attacking more. He's testing to see if Rosario has truly recovered from that knockdown in the previous round. Jermell throws a beautiful mix of left hooks to the body and left hooks up top. Rosario is the one coming forward, however. Jermell definitely uses his footwork to maintain his distance, or he'll step inside and clinch. In this round, Rosario's plan is to walk Jermell down with a reeking right style high guard. When Rosario steps onto the line, Jermell does one of three things. One, he'll step off of the line and use his movement. Two, he'll step inside to smother and clinch Rosario. Three, he'll punch Rosario as Rosario steps onto the line. Rosario steps onto the line one of two ways. Most of the time, he steps in with his high guard. Jermell either steps back or he fires off jabs and combos. If Jermell is close to the rope, he'll clinch. There are times that Rosario steps onto the line with a punch. In this case, Jermell easily slips or counters Rosario. Round three. In the beginning of this round, Rosario has made a slight adjustment. He is still pressuring forward. However, instead of walking onto the line with his high guard, he is stepping onto the line with mainly sharp jabs. So he gets on the line and he fires off sharp jabs. Again, Jermell gives up ground. Now, he is also looking to counter Rosario's jabs. If Rosario simply walks onto the line with his high guard up, Jermell fires off his own strong jabs. Rosario is pretty relentless at this point. He's relentless with his pressure. And I'm very impressed with Jermell's footwork and head movement. He is effectively nullifying Rosario's pressure. He's a phenomenal athlete who can smoothly shift from the front foot to the back foot and vice versa. This makes him pretty hard to hit. See, boxing is a sport. Like all sport, the more athletic you are, the better you will be able to perform. It is true, skills pay the bills, but having natural talent can take you a long way in this sport. Just look at Deontay Wilder. His physical gifts have brought him huge success in the sport of boxing. What I'm seeing in this match is Jermell Charlo is a superior athlete that is developing really good boxing skills. Round four. Again, Rosario comes out pressuring forward and Jermell is giving ground. This time, Jermell is firing off more jabs as Rosario steps into range. Jermell is trying to draw out Rosario's jab so he can counter over the top. Jermell just misses the overhand right off of Rosario's jab. Fight has settled into a predictable pattern. Rosario walks onto the line with his high guard, or he's stepping onto the line behind his jab. Jermell uses his movement to maintain his distance, or he blasts combos as Rosario steps in range. So let's look at Rosario's strategy. Oftentimes, this strategy is very, very effective. especially against less skilled opponents who can't effectively get off the line when a pressure fighter steps onto the line, making it very difficult to evade the pressure fighter's attack. The strategy is also particularly effective against an opponent who does not have the physicality to stand up against a fighter who is exerting the pressure. So, what if an opponent is skilled enough to get off the line against a pressure fighter? What if he has good movement and good feet? Well, is that skilled opponent simply running? Will he eventually tire? Thus, the pressure fighter catches up with him anyways. Now, I don't want to spend too much time on that, but we'll touch upon that some more after the next round. You know, this strategy is really effective in the amateurs. In the amateurs, a lot of fighters, they don't have footwork to really get off the line, so it's easier for a pressure fighter, especially a fighter who knows how to cut off the ring, catch up with his opponent. Now, even if his opponent is equally skilled as far as physical and ability, if the pressure fighter is going forward, then it looks to the judges that he's quote unquote making the fight. So he's getting the benefit of the doubt. All things being equal, when it comes down to skill and ability plus strength, against a pressure fighter in the amateurs, you gotta have the physicality, punching strength, footwork. So you have to have a lot of tools to really work against a really good pressure fighter in the amateurs as well as in the professional ranks. Round 5. Predictably, Rosario continues to walk down with Jermell. What's striking to me is that Rosario walks onto the line, walks in range to punch, but no further. Essentially, Rosario settles himself at the quote-unquote 1-2 range. He does not step into the pocket to throw power punches. Jermell still is giving ground, but he is not punching as Rosario steps into the range as much as he was in the earlier rounds. Instead, he's slipping onto the front foot to throw his counter left hook. It appears to me that Jermell's more effective power punches his left hook. It looks to me that punch is much more effective than his right hand, which he often throws it loopy. As a result of Jermell slipping over his front foot, the two fighters engage in exchanges more. What's notable to me is that this is the only time Rosario throws any hooking type punches or in exchanges. Rosario, at least in this fight, is essentially a 1-2 fighter, unless Jermell slips on the inside and force an exchange. Because Rosario only wants to step in that medium 1-2 range, he follows Jermell around and does not effectively cut off the ring. Rosario leaves a little too much space, which allows Jermell enough room to maneuver effectively. Jermell takes full advantage of this space. Jermell springs another trap in this round by bouncing a stiff jab off Rosario's high guard. He slips to the outside of Rosario's return jab and cracks him with a sharp and straight right hand. Rosario plays a dangerous game that eventually is going to get him KO'd. It's like he pressured forward without a real plan once he gets in range. I mean, a lot of fighters pressure forward. I mean, Mike Tyson, Triple G, they are come forward counter punchers. So it will invade your space, forcing you to punch and counter off of your punch. Whereas here, Rosario's just steps into range, oftentimes wait, and he doesn't punch off of Jermell's punching. It's like he pressure forward without a real plan once he get in range. What's the goal of a pressure fighter? The goal is to force exchanges, especially against the ropes where opponent cannot maneuver as well. Pressure fighter wants to batter his opponent with power punches. Power puncher wants to physically overpower his opponent. We all know great pressure fighters of the past. You got Armstrong, Frazier, Chavez Sr., Golovkin. A pressure fighter should be effective in cutting off the ring to herd the opponent towards the rope so they can break down their opponent. Now, what happens when you press a powerful puncher? It depends. Frazier pressured Foreman and was blown out. Then again, Mike McCallum pressed forward and sparked out Julian Jackson. So it just depends. Round 6. Early part of this round mirrored all of the previous rounds. Rosario pressuring forward, Jermell punching as Rosario steps into range. If he doesn't punch, he maneuvers away, or he clinches Rosario if he has to. Rosario did some good work driving Jermell to the ropes and firing off a series of power punches, but it was all downhill from there. Rosario's focus fell off. Instead of cutting off the ring, Rosario followed Jermell around. Jermell took full advantage of being able to maneuver and set his positioning. Jermell again laid another trap. As Rosario was pressuring forward, Jermell took a step back, creating space. Rosario stepped into that space and pushed out a jab, which Jermell saw coming a mile away. Jermell parried the jab and cracked Rosario with a left hook that hurt him badly. Rosario was on shaky legs. Jermell followed up right hand, dropped him. Jermell displayed really good body mechanics during this sequence. His weight transfer was perfect on that hook. He then pivoted on his front foot in order to position himself better to throw the follow-up right hand that put Rosario down. Very impressive by Jermell Charlo. Round 7. Jermell gives up slightly less ground in the beginning of this round. He's looking for opportunities to counter and hurt Rosario again. Rosario is still pressing forward. However, Jermell is pretty much staying in range looking for his opportunities. While Jermell is focused and looking for a shot, Rosario is listless. He's simply following Jermell around the ring, flinging ones and twos. The round is uneventful, but you can see that Rosario has made zero adjustments in this fight. None at all. Jermell, on the other hand, is focused on setting traps and is looking for his opportunities to hurt Rosario. He's fighting with purpose. Round 8, the last round. Okay, so what happened? For Rosario, it was the exact same thing. He steps onto the line with his high guard and waits. But this time, Jermell does not give ground. But wait, there's more. Jermell does something that Rosario totally expects. And he does something that Rosario not only does not expect, he flat out does not see it coming. Jermell fires his jabs into Rosario's guard, which Rosario anticipated. I mean, he's done that, 100 times before in this fight? But this time, Jermell immediately slammed a stiff jab laser straight to pit of Rosario's gut. To say that Jeison Rosario was not ready for this punch is an immense understatement. Jermell's body jab caught Rosario at exactly the perfect time. I imagine that Rosario was breathing in, or he was breathing out, or he was swallowing. I don't know. Look, Jermell's body jab totally incapacitated Rosario like I've never seen a body jab do before. It was shocking, a total WTF moment. But remember, Jermell only threw one other body jab the whole fight, and that was the very first punch of the bout. If I'm wrong about this, make sure you guys correct me in the comments. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, subscribe, and comment. I'm going to do the other Charlo brother next. After that, I'm going to do either Mayweather Canelo or Mayweather Gotti. So in the comment section below, please let me know what fight would you like me to break down. You could choose Mayweather Gotti, Mayweather Canelo, or choose your own fight. Let me know in the comments. Again, thank you guys for joining me today. God bless.